So let's talk about flash batteries. I am no expert in this topic, but I learned a couple of very important things about flash batteries recently, and I thought I would like to share those things in this video. So I've been doing macro photography now for like 5 years almost, and of course I'm using a flash most of the time, as most macro photographers do, and I've always had this very frustrating issue where you are shooting some insect, you take a few shots, but you don't really get the perfect photo. And then when you have the perfect angle and the insect is sitting there and you're like, wow, now I'm gonna get a really great photo of this insect. And bam, the flash does not work because it is exhausted because you took a few shots earlier and now the batteries are like tired. And this is so very frustrating, and I always use like no-name cheap batteries. So like a year ago, I decided like, I need to get some really good flash batteries so that I get less of this issue with the flash not working when I need it to. And I knew nothing about flash batteries at all, and I thought that the only metric that could possibly matter is the number of milliamp hours, which is like the capacity of the battery. So I went out and googled for batteries with the most milliamp hours possible. So after some googling, I found these batteries. These are the GP ReCyko Plus 2600. So it's 2600 milliamp hours, which is quite a lot for an AA battery. And since this was the only metric I knew about, or that I thought could vary between different AA batteries, I thought these are probably the best batteries you can get, and I decided to purchase them. And I tried them out, and they were perhaps marginally better than the cheap no-name batteries that I used earlier. So, but like, there wasn't a big difference. I still had this irritating problem with the flash not firing when I needed to in some situations. Usually you take maybe 5 or 10 photos in a row and then the flash gets a bit tired, and then when you're gonna do the next 5 photos, it will not fire, which is very irritating. And I thought that since I had purchased these like brand name batteries from GP with the 2600 milliamp hours, that was all that I could possibly do, right? Then a couple of weeks ago, I got an email from GP Batteries, or like their PR firm, and they had actually noticed in my video about the ProMist filter that I was using their batteries. That was very nicely spotted of them. I actually didn't even know myself that I was using that brand, because I didn't look at the brand that much, I just looked at the milliamp hours. And they were like, we have some new flash batteries that are optimized for speed lights and flashes. Would you like to try them? And I was like, yeah, sure. As long as you don't require me to do a video about them or anything, I am happy to try them out. Why not? And I wasn't expecting that much at all. And the ones they sent me are some very new batteries. They are called ReCyko Pro Photoflash 2000. So they are actually less milliamp hours than the batteries I used earlier, but the unique thing about these are that they are supposed to be optimized for photo flashes. And as I said, I wasn't really expecting that much of these. I was like, this is probably just some branding, like I would probably not notice that much of a difference, I was thinking. But I was very surprised, very positively surprised about these batteries. They work a lot better than any other batteries I've used earlier. I don't have these issues where the flash fails me after prolonged use. These are really, really good, and they really make a difference when I'm doing my macro photography. So I'm so happy about these batteries. And also I think the whole system that I have created is very smart. So you have this little case here that you can that you can store the batteries in, and it is also actually a charger. Have a look here. They have like a micro USB it's called, port here, so you can use any like phone charger to charge these batteries in this case. But more than that, they also sent me this like charging station, which has a display and everything. And as you can see, you can put two packs of these, whoops, in this charging station like this. So then you can always have one of the packs with you when you're out photographing, and the other one can be charging in here. So it's a very like intelligent system. So I'm not getting paid by GP to do this video or anything. The only thing they did was send me free batteries and this free charger. But I honestly can say that I love these batteries. They are great. Even though there is an even better option that I will talk about in a moment. But before that, when it comes to rechargeable AA batteries, I asked my followers on Instagram, what batteries do you use? And among my followers, I have some of the best macro photographers in the world who are very experienced and have a lot more experience than me in macro photography. And many of them said that they were using the Panasonic Eneloop Pro batteries. And I haven't tried these batteries myself, but I am assuming that they are on par with the GP ReCyko Photoflash batteries. I cannot confirm this, and the Photoflash batteries from GP are so new that I could not find any test or comparison between these batteries and other batteries. So it's really hard for me to say if the GP Photoflash batteries are better than the Panasonic Eneloop or not. But I can say this much, the Panasonic Eneloop batteries is like the classic choice that people who have an AA battery flash are using if they want to have the best possible batteries for that flash. So if you're looking to buy AA batteries for your flash, I would suggest look into the GP ReCyko Photoflash batteries or the Panasonic Eneloop. Both of them seem to be good choices. And I personally have only used the GP Photoflash batteries, and I can say I love them, and they are much better than any other rechargeable AA battery for flashes that I have tried. But as I said, I have discovered something possibly even better than the GP Photoflash or Panasonic Eneloop batteries. And that is to buy another flash from the beginning. And I actually got this tip from one of my followers on Instagram when I was asking about the different batteries and so on. That why don't I buy a flash with a lithium battery? And I did that. I have actually not even tried this flash yet. I am looking forward to trying it today or tomorrow. This is the Godox V350S, and the S stands for Sony. So it's just like this is the model for Sony cameras. They have, of course, for Canon and Nikon and so on. And what's different about this flash from the other flashes I've had before is that it does not use AA batteries, but instead it uses a custom made lithium battery that is made by Godox. And from what I have heard, this battery will deliver a lot better performance than AA batteries ever will, no matter what brand I use. And this battery is actually like 14.5 watt hours or something like that, which is double the amount of power that you have in two AA batteries. In theory, I will get twice as many photos with one charge of this battery as I will with two AA batteries in a flash that is of similar size. And if you like Godox flashes as I do, that is like my go-to brand for flashes, you should know that basically all of the flashes come in two different versions. Either the version that has a V in the beginning of the name, or the version that comes with a TT. So there is actually a TT 350 flash, which is exactly the same flash, but with AA batteries. So for all their flashes, they have a TT version and a V version. And the V version is the lithium ion battery version, which I would actually recommend you to buy. It is a bit more expensive, but you have to then calculate for buying a cheaper flash, but then also buying some very expensive AA batteries to get good performance. So then why not buy the flash with the lithium battery from the beginning and have a much better battery capacity per charge? This flash comes with a very nice custom charger, which has like a percentage meter and everything. I mean, it's hard for me to wholeheartedly recommend this flash before I've actually tested it, but in theory it should be even better than using the GP ReCyko Photoflash batteries. But to summarize this video, if you have an AA battery flash and you have this issue with your flash not always firing when you need it to because the batteries get tired quickly, then I can warmly recommend you to try out the GP ReCyko Pro Photoflash batteries. I think they are great, they are working great for me, and they are pretty good value for money, I would say, even though they are of course more expensive than many other batteries. And that's it for this video. What's your experiences with different flash batteries? Please let me know in the comments. And as I said, I am no expert in flash batteries, but I recently learned the things I talked about in this video, so please correct me if I am wrong about anything. And if you find a comparison between the legendary Panasonic Eneloop batteries and the new GP Photoflash batteries, please link it for me in the comments and I will check it out. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye, over and out.